A long time ago, in a universe much larger than our own, our giant star collapsed. Its implosion crammed so much mass and energy together that it created our wormhole to another universe. And inside this wormhole, our own universe was born. It may seem fantastic, but our theoretical physicist claims that such a scenario could help answer some of the most perplexing questions in cosmology. As always, we start at the edge of the universe.
Captain, I believe there's been a distortion in the space-time continuum.
Exactly. Okay. So if you ask yourself, can I distort it in interesting ways that might benefit what I want to do in the universe?
A wormhole, also known as an Einstein-Rosen bridge, is a tunnel with two openings at distinct points in time or space. It is predicated on the notion that nothing is completely flat or solid. Time, like everything else, contains little gaps and creases. At the tiniest scale, there is a region known as the quantum foam, where wormholes may exist. Unfortunately, these wormholes are far too small for people to pass through. Some scientists believe it is possible to trap a wormhole and make it large enough for travel. In theory, a wormhole could transport humanity to other planets, or even back in time, if the two sides of the wormhole were at the same location, but at different times. According to another theory, a wormhole could be a connecting conduit between a black hole and a white hole.
Well, if you have a black hole, what's on the other side? It would be like a white hole. I mean, why not? Right. Where everything only comes out.
Right.
Then how would you connect them? With a wormhole.
However, there is a major issue with wormholes, and it is tied to paradoxes. The grandfather paradox is a well-known conundrum in which someone goes back in time and prevents their own existence. This type of time travel would violate the fundamental principle that cause occurs before effect. As a result, a wormhole like the one described cannot exist. There are numerous stories in science fiction concerning traveling through wormholes. But it's considerably more complicated in reality, and we haven't even found one yet. Wormholes are expected to be extremely small, but as the universe expands, some may have widened. Wormholes are fascinating because they can connect not only various locations in our universe, but additional universes. Some scientists even speculate that moving one end of a wormhole in a specific way could allow us to travel across time. Astrophysicist Eric Davis says that with traversable wormholes, we might conceivably go into the future, or even the past. It will not, however, be easy. It would take a tremendous amount of effort to convert a wormhole into a time machine. Creating and using a wormhole is difficult enough. Cosmologist Stephen Hawking, on the other hand, believes that utilizing a wormhole for time travel is impossible. According to NASA's Eric Christian, a wormhole does not allow humans to travel back in time. Rather, it acts as a shortcut that brings distant regions closer together. Scientists have investigated adding exotic stuff to a wormhole to stabilize it so that people can safely travel through it. However, even adding ordinary matter may cause the wormhole to become unstable. Unfortunately, our existing technology is incapable of detecting, enlarging, or stabilizing wormholes.
It seems like the wormholes are inherently unstable, the big ones. And if you try to travel through one, it collapses.
But scientists continue to study and explore this concept, hoping that future technology will make it possible. However, there's an interesting theory proposed by theoretical physicist Nikodim Poplovsky. He suggests that a collapsed giant star in another universe could have created a wormhole to our universe. According to his calculations, conditions inside this wormhole might resemble those during the Big Bang, which could explain some mysteries about gravity and the expanding universe. And thus, we could very well be living inside our wormhole. However, further research is needed to determine whether traveling between universes through wormhole is possible. It's worth noting that various scientists have varied perspectives on this hypothesis, with some seeing it as more theoretical than practical. The key question is whether the requisite substance to build a wormhole exists. Speaking of traveling between universes, NASA has made a groundbreaking discovery in Antarctica, which may be a portal to a universe where time runs backwards. Parallel universes are popular in science fiction across languages and cultures. The concept of a universe similar to ours but in which we may be living a completely different life in circumstances vastly different from ours is enticing to say the least. In the 2020 Korean drama the King of the Kingdom of Korea travels to a universe where he lives as a civilian in the Republic of Korea. In the Chronicles of Narnia, four kids travel to a fantastical parallel universe of talking lions, evil witches, and one where they get to be princes and princesses. The possibilities are endless. But what if parallel universes are not just limited to sci-fi and fantasy? What if it is as true as you and I? What if one of the leading agencies of space research has found proof of a parallel universe? According to claims, NASA has detected a parallel universe where the laws of physics are opposite to ours. Where asteroids don't crash into a planet, but instead appear to leave it. In quantum mechanics, a parallel universe is theorized as existing alongside our own, although undetectable. 4 years ago, the Antarctic Impulsive Transient Antenna, known as the ANITA for short, stumbled upon something unusual. ANITA observed what appeared to be highly powerful neutrinos passing through the Earth on a few occasions. The telescope was able to detect neutrinos traveling from space and colliding with the Antarctic ice sheet. It detected these particles, but rather from originating from space, the neutrinos were discovered to be emanating from the Earth's surface with no source. The polar opposite of ours. A neutrino is a subatomic particle very similar to an electron. But it has no electrical charge and a very small mass, which might even be zero. Neutrinos are one of the most abundant particles in the universe. But because they have very little interaction with matter, they are incredibly difficult to detect. The ANITA detections occurred in 2016, then again in 2018, with no convincing explanation that could be reached using our physical principles. Since then, physicists have been trying to figure out whether these results can be explained by our present models of physics, if they are due to the experimental setup, or if something like a parallel world does exist after all. Our universe is enormous. Hundreds of billions, if not trillions, of galaxies swirl through space, each holding billions or trillions of stars. Some experts investigating cosmos models think that the universe diameter could be 7 billion light years big. Others believe it could be endless. Once upon a time, we assumed the Earth was the center of the universe, followed by the solar system and our galaxy. And we were always proven wrong. Isn't it feasible that our universe is just a speck of dust in the grandeur of the cosmos? Laura Mersin I. Outen, a famous cosmologist, asserts that evidence of parallel worlds may be observed in the night sky and that the fingerprints of such alternate universes can be discovered. According to Professor Mersin I. Outen, the key to detecting parallel worlds is to delve into the cosmic background radiation at the very boundaries of the visible universe. The Copernican principle, the concept that the Earth is not unique or special and that many other planets like ours exist, says that accepting the reality of other universes is the natural extension of this. As the concept of a multiverse, which was previously the topic of wild science fiction stories and fringe scientific hypotheses, has now become mainstream, Some leading physicists are working on ways of detecting and even gazing into the new worlds. According to the professor, the Big Bang, the genesis of our universe, would have left imprints on all hypothetical universes if they were all jammed together in an impossibly small space. These marks, she claims, could be observed today in the form of cold spots in the cosmic background radiation. Cosmic voids. Around 13.7 billion years ago, everything we know of was an infinitesimal singularity. Then, it burst into action, inflating faster than the speed of light in all directions for a tiny fraction of a second. Before 1032 seconds had passed, the universe had exploded outward to 1026 times its original size in a process called cosmic inflation. All of this occurred prior to the real expansion of matter known as the Big Bang, which was caused by all of this inflation. As inflation slowed, a rush of matter and radiation appeared, becoming the atoms, molecules, stars, and galaxies that inhabit the vastness of space that surrounds us. Some academics believe that the unexplained processes of inflation and the Big Bang have convinced them that multiple universes are possible, if not particularly likely. According to theoretical physicist Alexander Vilenkin of Tufts University in Massachusetts, inflation didn't end everywhere at the same time. While it ended for everything that we can detect from Earth 13.8 billion years ago, cosmic inflation in fact continues in other places. This is called the theory of eternal inflation. And as inflation ends in a particular place, a new bubble universe forms. These bubble universes are unable to communicate with one another, since they continue to expand eternally. We'd never get to the edge of our bubble, where it might collide with the next bubble universe over, because the edge is speeding away from us faster than the speed of light and faster than we could possibly travel. And even if we could reach the next bubble, our familiar universe with its physical constants and habitable conditions could be totally different from the hypothetical bubble universe next to our own. And, while opening portals to other planes of reality is not impossible, it is extremely unlikely. Traveling via metaverse or wormholes, like Rick and Morty do in practically every episode of the popular sitcom, would need around 110 billion electron volts of energy. The common sense rules of physics that we use every day may make sense to us, but at very small scales, common sense fails completely. At the quantum level, the empty vacuum of space is continually boiling, with tiny particles bursting in and out of existence. At the quantum level, the small particles that make up the building blocks of everything have no fixed location, only a blur of possible positions controlled by intricate probability laws. Many theoretical physicists believe that the fact that minuscule particles like electrons and photons do not have a fixed location in the cosmos is the final proof that there are many parallel universes. Is there a parallel universe and do wormholes have anything to do with it? The answer might be staring at us all along, but what do I know? So, would you like to travel to the other side of the universe, or stick with us here, at the edge of the universe? Until we meet again.